Good morning from Berat, Albania. We actually had a day off yesterday. It was one of them Albanian travel days, I guess. I've found the bus to Berat, but I can't find the driver. Turns out, wrong bus terminal. But we have made it to the UNESCO World Heritage town of Berat, and the views are incredible. We are actually staying on the gorgeous side of town so we can have a look at the prettiest side of town, which is Mangalem. We are just about to have our breakfast. We are actually staying at the hotel Ajkart, which was actually a really, really, really good find. That was a lot of reallys. Firstly, because up here where you have breakfast, you get a view over that, which is one of the main reasons you come here, to have a look at that view. It is incredible. The rooms are really, really well priced, and the owner is actually looking at me now because breakfast is ready, so we better go and do that. And look at all this. We have got an omelette, we've got our breads, we've got our goat's cheese, we've got a juice of some sort, we've got our coffees, we've got our fruits, we've got some sort of cakes. I don't know, I don't think we've had them before. Oh. That is so much.
Breakfast was amazing. They give you so much. We didn't even ask for anything. It was like a huge spread. You could have everything that you could ever wish for, but it's such amazing value. You have the gorgeous view over the town, and it's just such good value for money. Like, it's about £15 a night, which is just insane. I had the best night's sleep that I had ever had. Honestly, that bed is so comfortable. I just really like it. This is where we're staying. It's Hotel Ajka. It's really, really traditional and so cute.
Quickly, just to add, Berat is known as the city of 1,000 windows. So it was perfect when our hotel gave us two windows. So we are two of the 1,000 windows. I can just imagine many in Albania sitting out on their window ledge, enjoying an espresso, overlooking the old town. We are finally out. The good thing about this city and the location of our hotel is everything is a stone's throw away. We literally have the new bridge, which I don't know the name of, don't know when it was constructed, literally next to our hotel, which is perfect. It takes us over from Gorcha to Mangalem. Gorcha is actually the Christian side, and Mangalem was the old Ottoman side. This is in the past, that is now not the case. Way back, we are gonna take the old bridge. I feel like take the new bridge on the way out, old bridge, once we have all our history, we're all history-fied on the way back, which is the Gorcha Ottoman era bridge. I do like this new bridge, but for a new bridge, it shakes an awful lot, and I'm not really feeling to fall into, I think it is the Ozum River below. It is, can you feel that? This bridge is so wobbly. I think I'd rather take the old bridge out and home, but yeah, I would not want to fall in that river. It does not look the best color.
Have the same sort of thing. It's all very stony, it's all cobbled, and everything's just so cute. This is actually walking through the Mangalem old town village, would you say? I suppose you would say that.
It's like a small little village, right?
It is tiny. They're really, really narrow. I don't know how they get things up and down here. Like, I totally would be out of breath all the time. The little streets are lined with, obviously, like, guest houses, people's houses, small coffee shops, and loads of traditional shops which aren't actually open yet. Are we out too early?
We could be too early. You could literally get lost walking through the Mangalem quarter. Look at this wall. This is tight.
You can also get stuck through here.
Right, if I keep eating too much burek, I could literally, oh, we're out, get stuck in here. But it's so nice just to walk along the cobbled streets, walk amongst people's houses. Like, I don't know, it's just, I find it crazy that people still live here with the old Ottoman roofs. It's incredible. But we're trying to figure out how to get to the biggest site here, which is the castle, and I'm lost. We're lost?
We are lost.
We're lost.
We're down here.
I haven't got a clue.
We managed to take the right path after the castle, but why do castles always have to be so uphill? And we have made it up to the main viewpoint of Burat Castle. Entrance is 300 lek each. You obviously don't have to pay if you live here. There is 120 families that are living in, would you call this a village, a city?
It's a village within a castle. It's one of the only in the world, apparently.
Really?
I think Wikipedia madness. Said so.
Yeah, I mean, obviously most castles are normally just deserted, but it is actually 120 families living inside here, which I think is so, so, so cool. But the views from up here are amazing. You can see the old town, you can see the new modern town, which I didn't expect, did you?
No, not at all. You
I
can
didn't
see it. You can see the boulevard along there of all the bars and restaurants. It's such a contrast.
It's a big contrast.
Get over the views up here. They are so good. We are now walking up above the entrance, the castle gate. And as you can see behind me, there is a completely fully functioning village, which I can't really wrap my head around. It's sort of crazy to have a village still within an old medieval castle. I think it dates back to the 13th century. So being a village, being that there's restaurants, I think I'll be able to get a beer in the castle. We came back down from the castle because we wanted to eat back down in the town. There's a few places that we wanted to try out. We actually went to go to restaurant Manglin, which is known to be the most traditional and well-known restaurant for trying traditional Albanian food. That was closed, so we came into our old favorite that we actually came to yesterday, which is restaurant Wildor. It is right on the road back in the Manglin district of the old town. And the beer is actually the cheapest beer we have had in a restaurant in Albania. 150 lek for a pint. I can find a pint for £1. It doesn't even matter about the food. Not only the beer, we also knew yesterday this restaurant was really traditional, just the inside. We want to sit outside because there is a little bit of sun peeking through today.
How has that come out?
It's come out, right? It's come out for us. I've worn a jacket, and I don't know why I've worn a jacket. It's like nearly 30 degrees now. But yeah, it does do some traditional foods. A lot of the restaurants around the Manglin district will do traditional foods. If you walk up through the old cobble streets, you'll find somewhere to eat. But I highly recommend this place. We came here yesterday. It was great.
First thing that we have ordered is a traditional pie.
Doesn't it look
pie.
So different here to what we've had everywhere else?
And it smells different. It smells kind of minty. It looks really flaky pastry-fies. We have, I think it's spinach and cheese. I love the fact that it's homemade, like homemade
pastry. Pick it up. Just pick it up. You don't
pick
even
it
know.
Up.
Yeah, you'll be all right.
Yeah, but it's so flaky and warm.
I like this. It looks much more like a pie then.
Yeah, look at that. Look. That's so different. Flavoursome and hearty.
Right, and we have now got the main. I got this yesterday, so I had to get it again. It's actually like a risotto, but it's like a traditional risotto to Burat. So apparently aubergine, they call it eggplant here. I don't know why Albania is taking on the American side that they have. But anyway, apparently eggplant, I'm not calling it eggplant, apparently aubergine is one of the vegetables that is grown here. It's really traditional, and also a white cheese, which is from a cow, which is strange. Most of the cheeses we've had out here have been from goats. So I'm pretending I haven't tried it. I had this yesterday. It is really, really good. Thanks for that. Yeah.
Really helpful.
Mm-hmm. Really helpful, but it's really good that you can see that cheese. Oh.
It smells
so good as well, and they've got all their traditional herbs in it.
Exactly, just as good as yesterday. I'm not even going to tell you too much about it. Come here and try it.
And I've gone for my favourite, which
boring.
Is just a normal pasta. Yesterday I had something slightly different, but I thought this looks so good.
That food was too good. It's like a risotto that I've never had before. Risotto with a twist is the best thing I could describe it as. But the problem is when you have a beer and it costs £1, one becomes two become three. I become really, really tired. It's actually been quite a long day walking. It's actually quite hilly where we're at. So I'm a little bit tired. And I did say on the way back, we would take the old traditional bridge of Gorcha back across to Gorcha to our hotel. I prefer this bridge, Molly.
I think I like both, but I think the other one has a better view. This one...
New Meets Old.
Yeah, New Meets Old. This one's really old. It was originally built... Just wait for the motorbikes to go past. This was originally built in around the 1700s, and it was originally made by wood. I mean, I don't know why you'd have a bridge going across made of wood. I wouldn't have thought that would last very long.
It didn't.
Exactly. So then it was rebuilt in about the 1920s.
That's quite long, actually. It lasted about over 100 years, so that done well.
200 years then, really, wouldn't it? So it's remade in stone, it's up, it's standing. Is this the original one then? The 1920s, is this?
The 1930s, yeah. 1930s, the original was destroyed because of...
Floods. Yeah, which can't see any floods at the minute.
It does not look like it's going to flood. It's like half a river.
Oh, I have been sat at this desk for way too long. The beers made us so tired. We came back to the room. I managed to get some work done on my desk. Look at how cute this is. You can't really see it. Little desk here, just in the corner of the room. But Matt is actually choosing where we go for dinner tonight.
I've done my research. I'm getting changed back into the same clothes right now. But I am starving.
Molly is in safe hands. I've done my research and I think I know where I'm going to take. Am I taking you for dinner? Where I'm taking Molly for dinner. But I just wanted to show this. You've actually got the hotel still growing into like part of the mountain.
So cool.
Really traditional ornaments. But hold on, this is the most, like, the weirdest thing in this hotel. So, as you can see, there's taxidermy. This really creeps me out. Oh, it started raining. But we've made it to the restaurant. Wait until you see this. Right, slight change of plan, because the weather is not playing ball. We have decided to just come in to the restaurant that we're gonna eat at, which is Antigone, for a beer. You come in here mainly because the views overlooking Mangalim Quarter are incredible, and at night, that's the main thing to do, just sit out, have a drink, look at the views. I've got my beer, and I've got a plan B for food. Cheers.
Cheers. This is why we sit up here. This place is meant to have amazing food, but look at this view. And I'm happy.
Best view.
With my Tirana.
Best view in all of Berat. That is Albanian fast food.
This place is insane. How is this a fast food restaurant? Look at all this space. I think there's even an upstairs, you know?
There's like three floors.
But I think I'm quite lucky in here because we can then sit on our own.
Perfect, with two souvlaki on the way.
And chips.
And chips. How good does that look?
Look at it, it's massive.
You look, see? You don't need a fancy restaurant.
I'm happy with a gyro.
See, you don't always need a fancy restaurant for food. Souvlaki. This place, Heaven's Kitchen, incredible. If you want fast food in Berat, it's the place to come. It's the best way to end the night. Well, I say end the night, I'm gonna eat this, have a couple more beers, and that was Berat. I actually think I rate it, possibly, I'll tell you in the morning if I have a good night's sleep, higher than Giracasta. Souvlaki time.